Hi everyone. In the previous Chapter 7 video, we recorded sales transactions for Wine Country Gift Shop into the Sales Journal and General Journal. In this video, we'll continue the exercise by posting the sales transactions to the General Ledger for Wine Country Gift Shop. As always, I strongly recommend that you download and print the worksheets published for this lecture so you can follow along with the video and practice posting sales transactions to the general ledger. This exercise will be similar to the skills you learned in Chapter 4. For easy reference, this set of lecture worksheets includes the sales journal and the general journal that we completed in the first Chapter 7 lecture. Also included in the worksheets are two general ledger pages that we'll use for this lecture. The remaining pages in the worksheets we will save for a later lectures. As you learned in Chapter 4, we need to post each debit and credit in the general journal to the correct general ledger account. Look at the general journal shown as page 16 in this exercise. We want to post a $50 debit to sales returns and allowances. Turn to general ledger account number 451. Sales returns and allowances account 451. The year is 2018. I have filled in the date, February 16th. As you learned in chapters 4, 5, and 6, a description is not necessary in the general ledger unless it is a special entry, such as an adjusting entry or a closing entry. This is not a special entry, so leave the description column blank. The posting reference column is the journal page where the original amount was recorded. General Journal, page 16 in this exercise. General Journal, page 16, is where the $50 came from. So the posting reference is GJ16, debit $50, leaving a $50 debit balance in the account. Return to the General Journal page and record account number 451 in the posting reference column. Next, we want to post a $4 debit to sales tax payable. Turn to the general ledger account number 231. General ledger account number 231, sales tax payable. Date, February 16th. Leave the description column blank. Posting reference GJ16. Debit $4. Leaving a debit balance in the account of $4. Return to the general ledger page and post the account number 231 in the posting reference column. Let's post a $54 credit to accounts receivable. Turn to general ledger account number 111. General ledger, account number 111, accounts receivable. Date, February 16th. Posting reference, GJ16. $54 credit, leaving a $54 credit balance on account. return to the general journal and record account number 111 in the posting reference column. Now it's time to post the debits and credits shown on the sales journal. Page 6 in this exercise. Remember that one of the purposes of using special journals is to save time in posting the general ledger. If each of these sales transactions had been recorded separately as a journal entry in the general journal, we would have had to post each separate debit and credit into the general ledger accounts. But because we chose to use the sales journal, we will need to post only the totals shown on the sales journal at the end of the month, only these totals. We want to post a $1,215 debit to accounts receivable. Turn to general ledger account number 111. General ledger account number 111, accounts receivable. Date, February 28th. Leave the description blank. The posting reference should refer to the sales journal, page 6. So put S6 in the posting reference column. Debit $1,215, leaving a debit balance in the account of $1,161. This $1,215 debit minus the previous credit balance in the account leaves a debit balance of $1,161. Return to the sales journal and record account number 111 in parentheses below the accounts receivable debit column. Now we want to post this $90 credit to sales tax payable. Turn to the general ledger account 4, account 231. Account 231, sales tax payable. Date, February 28th. Posting reference S6, leave the description blank. Credit $90, leaving a credit balance in the account of $86. This $4 debit balance, offset by this $90 credit that we just posted, leaves an $86 credit balance in the account. Return to the sales journal and record account 231 in parentheses. Beneath the $90 total sales tax payable credit column. Let's post the $1,125 credit to sales. Turn to general ledger account number 401. General ledger account number 401, sales. Date, February 28th. Posting reference S6, credit $1,125, leaving a credit balance in the account of $1,125. return to the sales journal and record account 401 in parentheses beneath the sales credit column. That's all for this video. In the next video, we'll post the February sales related transactions from the sales and general journals to the accounts receivable subsidiary ledger. See you next time.